You know the drill already, more or less.
Oh my god, so many mirrors.
So you can see yourself. Oh, I have to move to the middle now. I have a lot of room! This is I'm happy. Alright. Remember the same crazy idea, right? Everybody quiet, that way we can do. You're gonna remember this. Contradictory word all the time. Don't move your hips, but let them move. I want your hips moves. What I say, what I mean with that, if you don't understand what I say, you can look at me right now. Don't move your hips. Oh, my teacher tell me to move my hip. My teacher tell me to move my hip. No, let them move. Why the hip moves? Because of balance. So don't keep it rigid. They tell me to don't move my hip. One teacher tell me to don't move my hip. Yeah, because you were doing this. And the other one told you to move the hip because you were like this. And then you did this. No, let them move. All the teachers, when they tell you something, is correct, but our brain understands whatever they want. They say just like that. So say, let the hip move to find your balance. You're gonna split the feet a little bit more. As if you're going for now, for this moment, it's not true forever. I don't want you to bend the knee. I want to use you move the hip. Split the feet, open the leg more, open the feet more. Because I want you to move and you're gonna feel you have a limitation of the axis. I look it right now so you can feel your axis. And don't move just the upper body, move the whole body. The hip is a tray who carry in a whatever martini you like. Apple martini, imagine the best martini that you like, right? Just put that in that martini in that tray. If you move the tray like this, the martini falls. So your upper body is a tray, is the martini. The upper body is the martini, entonces it cannot tilt. The shoulder cannot tilt. So sometimes when we go to embrace, we do this. Martini to the floor. No, the martini is in level. I can move forward or I can move back. I'm gonna do this, you're gonna do this with me. I'm gonna change my position. Don't change your position. My axis and my distribution of the weight is in the middle of me. I'm gonna change my position, you do not change your position. I'm gonna move forward and a back. And you're gonna find how much is the forward you can move. And that forward, everybody has to be much the same maximum, because it's more or less around the bunions of the feet. If you go backward, you see you're gonna go too much to the heel. You go forward, right here, you're gonna find the bunions. If you pass in that, what's gonna happen? You're gonna fall, right? So you don't want to go more than that, because you don't want to fall, because you don't have support right now. But I want you to feel your axis, how the axis go back and they go forward. I'm gonna change my position again. You do not change your position. So I'm gonna get forward and the back. When I found by now the heel more or less, because the center line of my body, that distribution even, I'm gonna go a little bit to the right, a little bit to the left. You're gonna see how you cannot pass too much. So you're gonna feel that normally the body gonna get stuck. The body gets stuck in one point or stuck in the other point. Yeah, if I want to continue going, I need to let the heel of the free leg to come out. So then I'm gonna be maintain the same level. I'm gonna go on top of my leg. And now I'm gonna send the energy to that heel. Find the distribution. Go to that side and let the heel of the leg to come out. Yeah, and then let the heel go to the ground, find the center, go with the heel off the ground. So at the same time that you're moving that heel, it helps you to push yourself to axis. But you don't want to be here. You want to be in line. Your shin It should pass in through the center of your pelvis and going to the arc of the feet. If you hear or you're eating, big eating is falling off of the cliff, that's wrong. You go to the side, here. Now we start to relax the knee and we let the standing leg participate the knee a little bit, or the standing leg to we have a relaxation. So when we have a relaxation, now this is true forever, permanently. Before I ask you to block and to keep it stiff, so you can feel the axis. By now what I need is you feel the distribution of the axis, the distribution of the balance, which is in the center line of the shin, pelvis hanging very much next to the arc of your feet. One more time to the other side. When we come back to the right side, I'm gonna go a little bit more, you're gonna see how your feet is gonna come in together. Yeah? And I want you to feel that your feet come together because your body says it. Your body says together. And because my relaxation of my knee or my standing leg is more, my foot right now could come into the ground, the heel. As I go there, my heel is up, my heel is to the ground, my heel is out of the ground, my heel come back to the ground. My leg is in, then my leg heel is out of the ground, my heel is go to the ground, my heel is coming out of the ground, my heel coming to the back to the ground. Yeah? Because sometimes I see that the foot is here, and then the foot is here, no. On the ground. Out of the ground. Out of the ground to the ground. Out of the ground, to the ground, out of the ground, to the ground. Out of the ground, to the ground, out of the ground, to the ground. Out of the ground, to the ground, out of the ground, to the ground. This is something you need to always remember to do. And then it's gonna come in more shallow and more close to the floor, but you need to find that even if your foot come out 1 millimeter away from the ground, it is out of the ground. Right here, foot to the front, flex and point. If you lose your balance, that's because you are too much to out of the side. You need to be inside of the free leg. Feet together. Out to the ground, out to the ground. Here, to the front, flex and point. Flex and point, and the hip should be backward or in line with the other one at least. If it's in front, it's not good, to the back. Feet together. Out to the ground, to the ground, out to the ground, to the ground. To the front. Outside rotation. And most of the time, if you can look at yourself in the mirror, it's better. Or to the front. Rotation to the inside. Don't look to somebody else, because somebody else will fall like you falling. Let's be going out, in, out, in, to the front, outside rotation. The body to the other side. It's okay. Somebody's pushing you. I know who's pushing you. The one who is on your left. The one who is on your left is pushing you because he's off balance already. And you look at him too. On reflections. Right? So now, lapis. Because in this lapis, I need you to think about the toes is going out, the heel is coming to the ground, we're going to the front. As we go into the front, the heel is going to come out to the ground because of the distances. So you go out, inner. sidestep, lápiz. Try to keep the foot out. Everybody can see me from there. Look, not the heel out, right? The toes out. Like a little car there, out. There, out. There, out. All right, stay there for a second, everybody. I have my standing leg soft, yes. Now, everybody see from there, right? Shoes, you see, color clear, right? Green, red, red, green, you see it, right? So now, in the up, you see, it's a lower area and up area, right? And the up area on the heel is a green, and the lower is red. And the up is red, and the lower is green. And the up area is a big body, red and green going together. But when you go to the bottom, the red doesn't like the green. The green love the green. When they are on the street, the green with the green. Or the red with the red when they are on the floor. When they go up to the apartment, green and red, they mix it up together. Because up here, they are very good with each other. When it's coming the other area, oh, red and green. Yeah, red and red. Red and green. Green and green. Right? Never happen this. Yeah, this never happened. Ah, except you itch in the feet, scratch with your heel. The heel to the arc, the heel to the arc. Heels looking for arc. Toes doesn't looking for the arc. Yeah, just there. To somebody who has on the other side of the camera, here. Green to green, red to red. Yeah, keeping that because I see some of you doing this with the lapis. You doing with the lapis this. And no. The heel, the toes, they don't like each other. The knee, they don't like each other. They don't want to see each other. Yeah, there you go. One more time. Lapis, out. Heel, to the, all the way to the arc and to the bunion in front, and then the toes go away. If you want to the back, the bunion you're gonna find the heel and the arc, and the heel find the other arc, and go to there. Side step. The heel like the arc. Ooh, honey. Beautiful. The other arc like the other heel. Ooh, baby. Oh, ooh. Have to mix up, right? I say here, right? There, and keep the balance to this side. I'm falling here and sad, right? To this side. No, you doing this? Look, you go with the toes to the thing. No, the arc to the arch. Eccole. We going one more time. And we send it to the side, and we arrive. And we have it arcing, and going there. And in here, again. The toes don't like the arc. The heel of the arch of that foot. The arch of that foot is loving by the heel. By the heel. Side step. Heel to the ground, heel out the ground, heel to the ground. Arching. Side step, arriving. We go side step again. Back lapis. It's a heel arcing, heel back. And back. and sidestep. Back. Back. Don't fight with the chair, guys. Eccole, side step. So now, the feet as you have it down there is in the same position all the time in this place. If you need to practice in this position to more firm, to have a strong, got a little ball like that. You put it in between the feet and the front where the bunions are. You put the heels together and you squeeze. So when you squeeze that, you're gonna feel the inner thighs working. And that makes you feel, oh, this is my feet are in place. That you have some things to do at home. So now most of the time, you're gonna be like this. I'm gonna dance and I come like this. Hi, hi, coming to the Milonga to dance. And the people look at you and say, no, thank you. Yeah, that's it. Try to think in those things. So basing in that, stay there if you want. Basing in that we are in this position, always the feet is in that place. Anytime your feet passing this line or this meridian or this axis or your ears behind, the foot got confused, the brain got confused, and it's normal. That's part of the human beings. So now in this moment, if you go with the foot backward, the tendency is going to do this, because the body gonna do that, because this is how the body defends itself to do that. But you need to remember that this sensation that you have, you sustain it to the back. In the same position. In the same position. So you have it here, the same position you're going back. Generally, the body gonna try to do this. And that's normal, because that's how the brain works. But you need to remember the feeling of that, and in that feeling, you send them backward. 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 Even if you send it to the side, the same. Even if you're not gonna cross behind, the same. Don't try to just go try to do this, no. If you're gonna cross in front, right, the body cross the line again, the same position, or the same position. Or when you're gonna do voleos, the tendency to do voleo be doing this. No, you keep it the same position, then you do the voleo. So the foot is in the right place. So the weak sensation, you have to remember this one here. With the ball in between the feet, you squeeze, and you have good exercise to remember permanently. So you go there, to the back, that's the voleo. That's the voleo. So you can practice in that, and by feeling. If you try to look at your foot, and the moment you look at your foot do this. Hi, and it look ugly. So you feel it, send it, and remember. After you get there and stop, you say, okay, let me see. Okay, it's clean. Or put the mirror, right? You can see yourself. The same happened to the front. We go in this position, voleo. Right? Voleo. Generally, when you go here, you try to do this. Okay. All crooked. Now, send it there, the same position that you have, you send it around, voleo. So you need to remember how your feet feel when it's in home. What is home? Here is home. Your feet feel that position in home, when you go there, voleo. Don't look to your feet. Anytime you look at anytime you look at your feet, it's gonna crook it up. Alright? Now, innuendo is there. Exercise is over. Guys, thank you very much. Let's go to practice. If you have any questions, you can ask.